blessed is our God, always now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to thee, O our God, glory to thee, O heavenly King, the comforter of the Spirit of truth, our Lord, everywhere present in those all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us and cleanse us from every impurity and save our souls with good wine. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, cleanse us from our sins, master, pardon our transgressions, Holy One, wisdom, heal our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, attend unto my supplication, give ear unto my prayer which comes out from deceitful lips. From thy presence hath my judgment come forth, but thine eyes behold uprightness. Thou hast proved my heart, thou hast visited me in the night, thou hast tried me, and now unrighteousness has been found in thee. Fetch my mouth, my mouth speak of the works of men, for the sake of the words of thy lips, I have kept hard ways. Prepare my steps and my pathways, that my steps may not slip. I have cried, for thou hast heard me, O God. Incline the ear unto me, and hear my words. Show the marvels of thy mercy, so thou forsakest them that hope in thee, from them that resist thy right hand. Keep me, O Lord, as the apple of the eye, and the shelter of thy wings, wilt thou shelter me from the face of the wicked, who have oppressed me. Mine enemies have surrounded my soul, they have enclosed themselves with their own fat, their mouth is spoken proudly. They have cast me out, have now surrounded me, they have inclined their eyes toward the sands of the ground. They have taken me like a lion ready for its prey, and like a young lion running in secret places. O rise, O Lord, go out to meet them and cast them down. Deliver my soul from the ungodly man. My sword from the enemy is out of thy hand. O Lord, do thou separate them from the few of the earth during their lifetime. Hate it from my hidden reserves, has their belly been filled. They have been satisfied with swine and have bequeathed their limits to their little ones. But as for me, in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be satisfied when thy glory is made manifest to me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let mine enemies laugh me to scorn. For none of them that wage on me shall be put to shame. Let them be put to shame that transgress without a cause. Show me thy ways, O Lord, and by thy cross teach me. Lead me in thy truth and teach me, for thou art God, my Savior. Comfort me, have I waited all the day long. Remember thy tender compassion, O Lord, and thy mercies, for they are from the ages. Remember not the sins of my youth, nor mine ignorance, according to my mercy. Remember me for the sake of thy goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore he will set the law for sinners in the way. He will guide them in judgment, he will teach them in his ways. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth, and truth and that seek after his covenant and his testimonies. For the sake of thy name, O Lord, pardon my iniquity, for it is great. Who is the man that fears the Lord? For him shall he set a law in the way that he has chosen. His soul shall abide in the midst of good things, and his seed shall inherit the land. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his covenant shall be revealed unto them. My eyes are ever toward the Lord, who shall pluck my feet out of the snare. Look upon me and have mercy on me, for I am one like God and am poor. The sorrows of my heart shall multiply, bring me out of my distresses. Behold my humiliation and my travail, and forgive all my sins. Look upon my enemies, for they are much caught, and with an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and deliver me, let me not be put to shame, for I have hoped in thee. The innocent and the upright have cleaved unto me, for I have waited on thee, O Lord. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all his troubles. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy tender shalt sprinkle me with visit, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than the snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. My humble bones shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and let thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from my guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in my righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I would have given it. With full burnt offerings, thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a broken and humble heart, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, and thy good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer young bulls upon thy altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. O champion of orthodoxy, teacher of purity and of true worship, the enlightener of the universe and the adornment of high arts, all wise God of Maximus, your teachings have been applied upon all things, intercede before Christ God to save our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Your holy pardon may have lead us, O Lord, through the sufferings have received and incorruptible crown from you, our God. For having your strength, you laid those adversaries and shattered the powerless fullness of demons, whose intercession saved our souls. Now and ever and under the ages of ages. Amen. On day of 12, the Lord, who binded us for us the fruit of life, we entreat you, O Sovereign, may the intercede together with the holy apostles, that we may be merciful to our souls. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord from day to day, the God of our salvation shall prosper us, our God is the God who saves. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, wonderful, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, wonderful, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, wonderful, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, who is in the dark, now he is the main pain state. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. That Christ's radiant light took up abode in your soul, O Lord, all blessed Father, and displayed it as an elect vessel, and a festive ends of the earth. O blessed Maximus, you explained by the God's doctrines with brilliance and clarity, proclaiming the transcendent and unoriginate Trinity to all. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. O thou, who art every season and every hour in heaven and on earth, worship and glorify thee, O Christ our God, long suffering, gratefully merciful, and deeply compassionate, who lovest the just and showest mercy upon the sinner, who callest on thy salvation through the promise of good things to come. Do thou the same, Lord, accept also our prayers in this hour, and direct our lives according to thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies by your prayer, mind, cleanse our thoughts, and deliver us from every affliction, evil, and sickness. Compass us about with thy holy angels, thy pardon and guided by their legions, who may obtain unto unity of faith and the knowledge of thy unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. cherubim and the forest, young and hidden, the seraphim, and the remaining virgin, you gave her to God, the Lord, truth, Theotokos, who magnify you, the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
To the prayers of the Holy Fathers of the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O Master God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and O Holy Spirit, one God, heaven, and power, have mercy on me, a sinner, according to thy judgments, which thou hast, and save me, and ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Save me, O God, by thy name, and in thy strength, without judgment. O God, hearken unto my prayer, give ear unto the words of my mouth. For strangers have risen up against me, and mighty men have sought after my soul, and they have not set God before their eyes. For behold, God shall seek to know what is the protector of my soul. He shall return evil unto my enemies. If I have thy truth, I will destroy them. Freely will I sacrifice in thee. I will give praise to thy name, O Lord, for it is good. For how of every affliction hast thou delivered me, to my eyes have looked down upon thy enemies. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, and despise not my petition. Extend unto me and hear me. I was grieved in my tribulation, and I was troubled at the voice of the enemy and the oppression of the sinner. For they turn iniquity upon me, and anger with their enmity with me. My heart was troubled within me, and the fear of death fell upon me. Fear and trembling came upon me, and darkness covered me. And I said, I will give wings like a dog, and I will fly away and be at rest. Behold, I have fled far away and have dwelt in the wilderness. I waited for God to save me from being hardness and strong tempest. Come, O Lord, and divide the times, for I have seen lawlessness and strife in the city. Day and night they go round about Babylon's walls. Iniquity, toil, and unrighteousness are in the midst of it. Usury and deceit have not departed from the streets. For if an enemy had reproached me, then I would have endured it. And if he that hated me had magnified himself against me, then I would have hidden myself from him. But if this thou, O man, my equal, the master of my whole household, and my own familiar friend, thou, who in companionship with me didst satisfy thyself with food, in the house of God we walked upon his board, let death come upon them, let them go down alive to the Hades, for wickedness is in their dwelling in the midst of them. After me, as God, have I cried from the Lord, heard me. Evening and morning, at night, I will speak and declare to me, he will hear my voice. He will deliver my soul and teach them that my fallen enemies, for they were meant without me. God will hear me, will humble them, even to be that is before the ages. But there is no change for them, because they are not for God. He has stretched forth his hand in retribution, they have defied his covenant. They who scattered the anger of his countenance and their hearts with greater righteousness than one and that they are in perils. Cast thy fear upon the Lord, and he will nourish thee. He will never prevent the righteous to be shaken. The thou, O God, shalt remove them to the dead corruption. Sin and blood and treachery shall not dwell half the days. But from the Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwells in the help of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord God, my protector, and my refuge, he is my God, and I will hope in him. For he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the falcon's horn. With his shoulders he will overshadow thee, and under his wings shall I trust. With his shield his truthful and his compass thee. Thou shalt not fear the terror of the night, nor the earth of thy full day, nor that which walks about in the darkness, nor calamity, nor even in the day. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. They shall not come nigh unto thee. Only with thy might shalt thou behold and see the reward of sinners. Hallelujah, 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 glory to you, O God. Glory Lord, have mercy, Lord, mercy, Lord, have mercy. O champion of Orthodox Christian Church, worthy of true worship, the enlightener of the universe, and the one of the hierarch, all wise Father, Maximus, your teachings have gained with light upon all things, and receive the poor Christ God to save her soul. You are due to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Your holy, modern man, fixed, O Lord, through whose suffering has received an incredible account, and you are God. Your happiness and healing those adversaries and shatter the powerless boldness of demons, whose intercession save our souls. Now and ever and to the ages of ages, amen. As we have no boldness because of the multitude of our sins, O Virgin, they are vocals, and deceive the sin who is born of thee, and much more the prayer of the mother able to incline the master and to his kind heartedness. Despise not the supplication of sinners, O pure one, for the merciful and kind to save the people who condescend to suffer for us. Let thy tender mercies quickly go before us, O Lord, for we are become exceeding thy glory. Help us, O God, as we live for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us and cleanse us from our sins for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, we are Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, we are Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, we are Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and peace be with the ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, cleanse us from our sins, master, pardon our transgressions, Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Glory to the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to ages of ages.
Amen. You shine forth in the mount like lightning, glorifying Christ through your struggles and death as a martyr. Therefore, you have received an unfading crown of great martyr name of Jesus. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. O God, who in every season and every hour in heaven and on earth, have worshiped and glorified the Christ our God, long-suffering, greatly merciful, and deeply compassionate, who loves us, and accept all our prayers in this hour, and direct our lives according to thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, guide and guide our minds, cleanse our thoughts, and deliver us from every affliction, evil, and sickness. Compass us, adopted by holy angels, required and guided by the legions, you may attain unto unity of faith and the knowledge of that unapproachable glory, requested art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, redeeming virgin, favored to God the Word, through Theotokos, who magnify you. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers of the Holy Fathers, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O God, the Lord of hosts and the fashion of all creation, who in thine incomparable tender mercy did send down thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of her kind, through his precious cross, did scare us under the handwriting of all of our sins, thereby triumphing over the principalities and powers of darkness. Do call the same Lord and Master and Lover of mankind, accept also these prayers of thanksgiving and supplication from us sinners, and deliver us from every deadly and dark transgression, and from all the visible and invisible enemies that seek after us into his arms. Hail to the blessed of the earth, you let our hearts and minds be full of your thoughts, the wounds and sores of thy love, that will be never to be guided by thee and the life beholding thee, the eternal life and our hand and food. May all throughout and season to praise and peace and be with thee. The Father who lives without beginning, together with his only begotten Son, and mine, all holy, good, and my creative spirit, now and ever. Amen.
Bless, Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Metropolitan Deacon, for our Archbishop Alexander, for the honorable priesthood of the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for those serving in the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. Travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O
Lord.
Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Holy, O Lord.
Glory to the adore, glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to thy name, O Most High, through the prayers of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us. To declare thy steadfast love in the morning, and thy faithfulness by night, through the prayers of the Theotokos, the world is established. Christ, God, to save our souls.
God, and to the Holy Spirit, now.
Sanctify us.
Teachings. thy people gathered in thy holy name. Be our helper and defender in this day of affliction. Thou knowest our weakness, thou hearest our cry of repentance and contrition of heart. O Lord, who lovest mankind, deliver us from the threat of the coronavirus. Send thine angel to watch over us and protect us, grant health and recovery to those suffering from this virus. Guide the hands of physicians and preserve those who are healthy. Enable us to continue to serve our suffering brothers and sisters in peace, that together we may glorify the most honorable and majestic name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever into ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray to the Lord, ye catechumens.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy on them.
Lord, have
that He may
mercy.
Teach them the word of truth.
Lord,
that they He may reveal
mercy.
To them the gospel of righteousness.
Lord,
that He may unite
mercy.
Them to His apostolic church.
Lord,
save them, have mercy on them, help them and keep them, O God, by Thy grace.
Thank you.
kingdom, always, now, and ever, unto ages of ages.
You and all Orthodox Christians and the Lord our God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Maker of heaven and earth and of all things visible and invisible.
And that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ.
Amen. Blessed Lord, Master.
Making the change by thy Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
That they may be to those who partake for vigilance of soul, for the remission of sins, for the communion of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, for boldness towards thee, and not for judgment or condemnation. Again, we offer thee this rational worship for those who fall asleep in the faith, ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit. Especially for most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary.
Thank you.
immaculate spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
To thyself and give us rest to those who are on heavy laden. Thou hast not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Cleanse me from every sin of flesh and spirit. Teach me to fulfill holiness and purity, but having the testimony of my own conscience clean, and having communion of our holy things, and your reunited with their body and blood, and may have to dwell in body and me, with the Father and my Holy Spirit. The Lord Jesus Christ, my God, in the kingdom of my most pure life, and me the judgment, whom may I become weak in soul, and body by partaking in an unworthy manner. But grant me to receive communion of thy holy things without condemnation, even to my very last breath, and by them to receive communion of the Holy Spirit, the vision of the journey of eternal life, and acceptable answer of thy judgment.
In the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord is God and has revealed himself to us. Receive the Lord, ye heart.
Thou art art our sanctification unto thee, dear Son of glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, who blesseth those who bless thee and sanctify thee, turn by thy divine power and forsake us not to put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee, dear Son of glory, thanksgiving and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Of the venerable Maximus the Confessor, and of Neophytus, whose memory we keep this day, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind. There's the prayer that the priest silently reads before the reading of the Holy Gospel, and I think it encapsulates very much the teachings of St. Maximus, so I'll read it for us right now. Illumine our hearts, O Master, who lovest mankind, with the pure light of thy divine knowledge. Open the eyes of our mind to the understanding of thy gospel teachings, and plant also in us the fear of thy blessed commandments, that trampling down all carnal desires, we may enter upon a spiritual manner of living, both thinking and doing such things as well pleasing unto thee. For thou art the illumination of our souls and bodies, O Christ our God, and unto thee, dear Son of glory, together with thy Father, is the out beginning of thine all holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. St. Maximus has a very beautiful vision of what the Christian life is, and that is that we are priests, all of us, Christians, those who have been baptized and sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, to offer up thanksgiving from this world. That we are all offering up in our interactions with the physical world, the created order, and offering up giving thanks up to God. And we see this from our dinner table, right, where we bless God for the food that we are able to eat and to sustain us. And even as we come to the spiritual table, to the altar, that we, in bringing our lives, bringing all of the things that we struggle with, those that we know that are struggling, that we intercede for them, that we ask for God's mercy, that we are basically, in all of this process of praying, of thanksgiving, of worship, are
spiritualizing things. And I don't mean spiritualizing things as in making it physical things into invisible things or some, you know, fleeting things, but I mean allowing and recognizing what is true about the created order, that God is present, filling all things, as we say at the beginning of our prayers and our appeal to the Heavenly King. In the life of St. Maximus, as we had in the Gospel reading, as we stand as priests, all of us, at the head of creation, interceding, being that kind of intermediary zone where we are taking up the created order and offering it up in thanksgiving to God, there are those who stand against this. It doesn't really make sense if you actually know what it's about, what the attempt of being a priest of the created order is, but as our Lord and those of us who are struggling to follow him, that there is those that are set against that priesthood, those that do not want to give glory and honor to God, but want to rather sow discord. And we especially then have to think about the ways in which we misuse the created order, the ways in which those, by those I'm talking about, especially demons, evil spirits, but also the things that we have, habits and things that we have allowed us to encumber us so that such that we don't give the thanks, give praise to God that is rightly due to him. But it is God and Jesus Christ who, suffering for us, showed us the example that all of us, even his servant Maximus, that the Holy Spirit will be with us because the world will be against us. Now, the world, I mean just the reality of the struggle of life. It doesn't have to be, you know, in the Gospel reading we have it to be a very, you know, be drug before magistrates or the synagogues as the apostles were, or as we read through the book of Acts just recently. That might happen. God knows. If it happens, God give us grace. But if it doesn't happen, there's still the basic witness that we are called to, the times where we are in some ways put on trial, in some ways pressured, and in some ways asked to renounce him, if not explicitly by our words, then in the way that we live. So let us rely on the grace of God to implant in us the fear of the blessed commandments, and doing those commandments that we may trample down upon all of the fleshly aspects, the carnal aspects, the things that so beset us that we have not yet been able to submit to the Holy Spirit to spiritualize, to bring into full communion with God. And it is St. Maximus, who is our heavenly intercessor, a great teacher and guide in the ways in which we may spiritualize our flesh, so as the prayer says, that illumine our minds, but also our bodies, so that we may become witnesses in this world of the glory of our God, and of his Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our champion of life, the taxi teacher of purity and of true worship, enlightener of the universe and the torment of the high heart. O wise Father Maximus, you have enlightened all by your teaching into secret Christ.
Thank you.
asking you whether to be a partaker of our holy things. I thank thee for the awesome and immediate knowledge can be unified, most pure and heavenly gifts. But O Master, who loves mankind before our sakes to die and rise again, and gave us to us these awesome and life-creating mysteries for the good and sanctification of our souls.
Lord, reach the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages.
glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You received and grace from heaven, O blessed and venerable John Chrysostom, and taught all by your mouth to worship one God in the Trinity. We praise you worthily, for you are an instructor who reveals things to the body. Now and ever and unto the ages of ages, Amen. Steadfast protectors of Christians, constant advocates before the Creator, do not despise the cry of a saint. Then your goodness comes speedily to help us in calling you on faith. Hasten to hear our petition and to intercede for us, O Theotokos. Lord, have mercy, Lord, 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 have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, the more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, the maiden virgin who gave birth to God, the Virgin of Theotokos, we magnify you, and the name.